The impact of COVID-19, healthcare costs, and consumer spending are top challenges U.S. business owners, including Black entrepreneurs, face as we settle into 2021. A new Bank of America survey shows recently Congress designated $137 billion for second draw loans as part of a larger funding and relief package. The bill was signed into law on December 27th and includes a total of $284.5 billion for PPP loans. Well, joining us now to talk about the new loan is the owner of Melba's Restaurant and president of the New York City Hospitality Alliance, Melba Wilson. We're happy to have you with us today.
Hi, Brittany. Happy to be here. Sorry under these circumstances, but happy to be here nonetheless.
And we're happy to have you. So, Melba, we know early during the pandemic, 41% of Black-owned businesses shut down between February and April of last year across the country. How'd you manage to stay afloat above all of this?
You know, Brittany, it's interesting. Every year we come up with a word. And unbeknownst to us, this year in December, our word was pivot. Last December, December 2019, our word was pivot. And we had no clue as to how that word would affect our lives. What we did mid-March, we sat down with the entire team. I am a single owner. I don't have any partners or any investors. However, I do look at my restaurant family as my partners, and sat down with them and explained to them what was going on. And collectively, we came up with an idea on how we could stay afloat and at least keep some of our employees working. And we had to pivot. We changed our hours, Brittany. We used to operate from 5 to 11. We started operating from 12 to 12. We circulated the staff. Starting out before the pandemic, I had 39 people, and we had to bring that down to 11. So how do we keep those 11 occupied? And we basically did it by seniority. But then we were able to weave in other employees so that they could have some type of income coming in. We actually became more active on social media. So there are just little things that we could do. But we also gave away, we also contributed to the community, to the neighborhood. And that was something that we were just doing, because when you're in the restaurant industry, you're actually a giver by nature. But it actually worked in our favor, and we got called for paid events in order to feed frontline workers, which was great, because then I was able to bring more of my restaurant family and employ them, put them back to work.
So you were basically rolling with the punches and able to keep at least 11 of 39. So were you actually able to benefit from the first round of PPP loans? We know not everyone was able to get their hands on that money, and many Black businesses and other small business owners like yourself said it was more difficult for them compared to white and larger businesses.
Oh, that is such a true statement. So I'm going on my 17th year in business, and I pretty much banked with a big bank, so to speak, for many, many years. And as soon as that application came out on that Monday, we were there, application was filled out. We submitted that application Monday afternoon. Tuesday went by, Wednesday, Thursday. Brittany, we didn't hear anything back from the bank that we had been in partnership with for all these years. Finally, we got a call from a CDFI, True Fund, a community development financial institute. And they're used to dealing with small businesses, and we've had a great relationship with them for a new place that I just built out. And they called to see if we had gotten funded. We told them that we had not, sent them the same application that the bank said, finally, when my CFO called, they said, oh, we need more information. We sent them that same application, and 5 hours later, we were approved. So I highly recommend that small businesses go to CDFIs and go to smaller banks in order to get funded. The story was not just for me. This was a story that when I spoke to so many other Black restaurants and small business owners, it was a story, unfortunately, that we shared. I, of course, no longer bank with that big bank. I bank with people that bank on me, and I bank with people that appreciate my business.
That's some great information there. Well, if you're able to get some of the money a part of this next draw, how big of a help will it be to your business?
You know, the PPP loan is like putting a Band-Aid on an elephant. As a restaurateur, we really need Congress to pass the Restaurant Act it's $120 billion. And restaurants are the second largest private employer in this country. And when a restaurant closes down, it's not just a mere space that you're looking at. You're looking at our paper goods suppliers. You're looking at vineyards. You're looking at produce farmers, fishmongers, meat markets, delivery truck drivers. So it's not just a mere space. You're looking at a myriad of different businesses that this affects. And just like in 2016, there was a bailout for the car industry. There needs to be a bailout for the restaurant industry. And I think that it needs to be considered that we are the second largest employers in this country. And all things considered, the Restaurant Act really needs to be passed.
And Melba, we only have about 20 seconds left. I want to make sure our viewers know where they can find you. I saw all your good fried chicken and catfish and everything listed on your website. People got to know where they can find you really quickly.
I'm born, bred, and butted in Harlem. Melba's Restaurant, 300 West 114th Street, right on Frederick Douglass Boulevard in the heart of Harlem.
Awesome. Melba Wilson, thank you so much for your time today, and good luck to your business for the rest of 2021 and beyond.
Thank you.
All right, well, still to come, find out why the National Park Service is closing off the Washington Monument to visitors. We're going to discuss this and more when BNC Now returns.